complex.
Thank you.
All right. Can everybody rise? We're going to be doing the Pledge of Allegiance.
A lot bit apparently,
But I promise you, we, and when I say we, I mean the people who love you and care about you, your parents, your grandparents, your guardian, your teachers, your principal, you know, they're all throughout the year. So your 12 years of one through 12 school have been hardening because they care about you and because they love you. So I just want you all to take a moment to just stand up and turn around and wave at them and give them a big, big thank you. They deserve it. And by the way, they're still going to be bothering you for a long time. Like, I'm 36, and my parents are still on my case about stuff, but I know it's because they love me. You guys worked really hard, and you're still schooling, or there's still job training, whatever you're going on to. And I see our salutatorian and valedictorian here, and I know they must have worked very hard for those grades. I just want to impress one thing upon you. Often the grades feel foreign to you. You get a high test score, and that's reflected on your report card. You do your homework, and you know, your teacher calls your parents. It's like, you're missing two assignments. What are you doing? And it's about numbers, but you are so much more than those grades. Those grades are just, in my view, a poor reflection, but a reflection of the work that you do. But it is very important, I think, for us, especially with what we're seeing in our country now, what we're seeing in our city. If you've been paying attention to news, there's a lot of hard times ahead. And I just hope that all of you remember that those grades, that hard work, is for a purpose. It is so that you all can do better for yourselves than your parents were able to do for themselves, that you could do better for your family than your parents were able to do for you, but importantly, that you do something for your community and something to make the world a little better for those around you, that some of those very people that helped you get here, or some of the people you've never met and never will meet, but need the opportunity just as you had to get a great education. So I leave you with that, to please continue your work, not just for yourself, but for those around you. And I just, again, a hearty congratulations to everyone here, and of course to the parents and the teachers who helped you all get here. Thank you.
Greetings, NTEC families, friends, NTEC staff, and most importantly, the class of 2022. I'm Ms. Hunter Freeman. I am one of the assistant principals at NTEC, and I am honored to be here to celebrate and celebrate you today and this year especially. It's been a long 4 years. You started your high school career at the same time I started my tenure at NTEC. I remember looking back at what seemed like then your baby faces in our first ninth grade town hall. Some of you or us had no idea what to expect in the next 4 years. And none of us could have predicted these seemingly insurmountable obstacles that have shaped the past 2 years and fundamentally changed the way we view the world and the people in it. Life is unpredictable, and you can see that in the way the world has been in the past. Yet even through all of the events you all have strived to get through, this moment shows that you've not only proven that you have the academic skills, you've met the New York State requirements to be here in this moment, but it shows that you have perseverance, resilience, and courage. We wish you the best in everything you do, and you always can come back to NTEC. I would like to introduce Mr. David Weisberg. Many of you, all of you, know him. He has dedicated 6 years as an AP at in tech, and he's so dedicated and committed, he decided he wanted to take on the principal role. He has been so dedicated to the work, the mission, the vision, all the fundamental things that NTech means to everybody in this room. And so at this time, I introduce to you Mr. David Weisberg.
Good morning, graduates. Welcome, students, parents, guests, and staff. It is an honor and a privilege to be here to celebrate with you today, to celebrate all the hard work you have accomplished during your high school career. I too started when you started, but as sixth graders. And so to see this accomplishment for those of you who started with us in sixth grade is amazing. Your character, your growth, your perseverance is beautiful to see. I would like to thank Councilmember Dinowitz for coming today, for his committed support for our community at NTech and the community in general. A thank you for our Superintendent Maribel Hulla and her team for their support for lighting the way for our leaders of tomorrow. I would like to thank our administrative and guidance team for ensuring our scholars met this moment. And I need to thank our resilient NTech Academy staff. They have worked endlessly through the pandemic to assist our scholars with not just academics, but navigating the challenging world we live in and the new norms we face. And lastly, to thank our amazing PTA and Title I members for working collaboratively with our staff to create a cohesive environment and supportive setting for all. One thing I've learned as an educator is that young people are adaptable and strong. The past few years have not been easy. We had to leave our regular learning environment, learn remotely, learn new ways to socialize, learn new health standards, and manage our fears and anxieties. It's important that we acknowledge how much you have accomplished and how much you have learned. Not just in school, but about the world, life, and most importantly, about yourselves. You show your excellence proud. Excellence is being intentional and deliberate in your actions, in particular when facing obstacles. Excellence is ensuring a space for our scholars to be seen and heard, for you to have space to engage in the educational process and not just be compliant or passive. The world, as you watch the news and experience it yourself, is not easy. It's challenging, not just personally, but the way society treats people. Holocaust survivor Elie Wiesel said, we must always take sides. Neutrality helps the oppressor, never the victim. Silence encourages the tormentor, never the tormented. Speak. Let your voice be heard. I know that you have learned the foundation of our social action skills and will continue to develop them for your own success and for the good of humanity. Families, it is important to acknowledge your commitment to your scholars' success. Without your support and guidance, our partnership would not be possible. It is vital for our school, our families, to work together for the success of our scholars, our community, and our society. So I think you all deserve a round of applause. Students, you have exhibited all of our core values that NTech has in the past few years. I have seen you work as a team. I have heard your compassion for each other. I have witnessed your commitment for success. I have seen your fight for diversity. And I have encountered your growth which is demonstrated here today. I mentioned your excellence before. What does it mean? Excellence is finding joy and passion in life, your educational future, that you understand failure leads to success, that you are fully committed to yourselves. Excellence is in you, and no one can take it from you. Excellence is having purpose and being positive. Let the world see you shine. InTech will always be here. One of my joys is speaking with alumni when they return, hearing about their growth and success. So many of our graduates continue to come back, and not just to tell us how they're doing and what they're up to, but to work at InTech Academy. They also come back to engage our current students, and I know a lot of you, if not all of you, have had that experience speaking to our alumni about their college experience, about their work experience, about their life experience. And I know they love coming back to share that with you. I wish you much success in your next chapter, and I look forward to hearing about your growth when you return. I wish the best for your future. I am positive that you will all make continued contributions that will create a more just and equitable society. Class of 2022, congratulations.
And now we'll hear from our celebratory Daniela Ashley.
However, we cannot forget that if we recognize that our growth moving at a steady pace, that it is inevitable and unstoppable, that is when we can accept the changes. The reality is that we have evolved. Evolution takes time. Evolution causes growth. We were going to have experiences and grow from them regardless. But then about halfway through our process, 2020 happened. We went remote, suddenly. But together, as a class, we were shaped by the occurrences of 2020 and the subsequent year of mostly remote learning. It seemed at times that our ability to be joyful was taken, but we found a way. So many people suffered through previously unimaginable hardships, and yet we are all here today celebrating. We had spirit days and fundraisers and student-led conversations, really intelligent and relevant conversations on the things affecting our society, well, on the things affecting our growth and future as a society. We discussed the stereotypes of blackness, the prejudice of language, and gender roles. Thinking about these issues brought our community together, even through tiny webcams, laggy Wi-Fi, and unreliable mics. Despite the intensity of the challenges we faced, it was through overcoming those challenges that we were able to make such a strong and vital connection. You were there. You remember this. You remember that the easiest thing to learn from online learning was surviving on one brain cell, what eye strain is, and the quickest way to a backache. But conversations weren't the only thing. Conversations weren't the only way we made the best out of our situation. How many of you also had camera issues? Senior year started and ended too fast. It seems like we literally just got back to the school building and all of a sudden we're leaving. There were times when we wanted school to just be over. In March, I was literally hoping for June to hit quick. But now, I wish we were back at Dave & Buster's again. At Dave & Buster's, we had so much fun. Like, we were really living our lives. But there comes a time when we must do more than just live our lives. There's a saying in my mother tongue, Vigan language, which goes, voila, à four. This roughly translates to, we cry for life. Oftentimes, when we hear the word cry, we think about someone shedding tears as a result of emotional or physical pain. You might also think of the word to mean to call out for something, like the way someone would cry for help. What we often forget is that crying can commemorate happy times in life. It can be silence, and it can be hopeful. Crying for life means to call for life, and be hopeful to live another day. This saying means that as long as you have life, there is nothing that can stop you from being who you want to be. There are many aspirations one may have in life. You may desire to be financially stable, achieve your dream career, buy that Tesla, reach a state of self-acceptance, or simply enjoy everyday life. Regardless of what you have in mind, it will never come to fruition unless you work hard, make the best of each day, and take time for yourself to rest. Your dreams will never come to fruition unless you grow. I wish I had listened when they said that 4 years fly by. Although not every moment in high school was enjoyable, God has used each of them to mold us into the people we are today. One of the greatest lessons we learned from all our years in high school is that life doesn't just happen at work or at school. It comes from the places where there is no curriculum. We learned what it means for time to slow down and speed up again. I learned I must slow down, enjoy the moment, and explore what I love. But I remind myself to be present and use my knowledge for the future. I've learned to acknowledge when I don't know something. I've learned to give myself credit, especially when there's a temptation to compare myself to my peers. As I bring my speech to a close, I would like to share a poem written by one of my favorite poets named Aisha Adams. It goes like this. Leaves grow on the tips of trees. Slowly but surely, summer begins. We watch the rebirth, not paying attention. Then June comes with surprised expressions. It's summer already, but we miss spring. Our mind is disconnected. It's never ending. We forgot what blossoms from soaked dirt. Forgot the showers, puddles, smell of earth. Now we exist with sun-kissed skin. It's summer, now fall begins. Just like the four seasons, there are many changes we'll go through in our lives, and these changes can happen very quickly. Many of these transformations seem unpleasant at first. In the long run, they are vital to who we are and where we're headed in the future. But we wouldn't realize the importance of these seasons in life unless we take time to self-reflect and pay attention to the details of each season. No matter what comes your way, as the poet Aisha Adams says, always remember to watch leaves sprout from empty branches, listen to the rain, smell the fresh dirt, and experience this cycle. My fellow graduates, I wish you nothing but the best in your future endeavors. Whatever shell you might find yourself in, know that you are fully equipped with the tools to grow, and one day, you will be able to tell your story. It will be difficult at times, and you might feel like giving up, but know that you are more than a conqueror. I believe in you, and you should believe in yourself too. Thank you, and congratulations.
Thank you, Daniela. So at this time, I'd like to introduce our keynote speaker. Our keynote speaker is somebody who's been a collaborator and partner with us for a while with our debate league. Avisha Moody Mehta is the co-executive director of New York City Urban Debate League, where she previously served as co-chair of the board of directors. She has a BS in finance and international business from the Stern School of Business at NYU and a JD from Columbia Law School. After working on Wall Street as a corporate lawyer, she decided to dedicate her time to her true passions, family, and public service. It has been a privilege to work with the students from across New York City, and especially InTech Academy, to help them find their voices so they can become the next generations of empowered leaders. Please welcome Avisha Moody Mehta.
Good morning, graduates. How does that sound? Because the InTech Village is one awesome community. Graduates, take a look around and see everyone who is here. Families, friends, educators, coaches, community members, plus all the people who could not physically be here but are here with us in spirit today. They say it takes a village to raise a child, and this is your village. Take a moment to reflect on its strength and how it has powered you through the last 17 plus years. How you, with the strength and sacrifice of your community, got here today. To this momentous occasion, your high school graduation. There are days that are hard, and there is much work to be done. And we'll get to that in a moment. But right now, be present to all of this energy. And like a solar-powered battery, take it all in for the days that are a little less sunny or even stormy. But don't worry about the stormy days, because you, my friends, are Bronx strong. You are New York City natives. You hail from the greatest city in the world. So let's talk about what that means. I think we've discovered that the rest of the world, or even just the country, is a lot different from New York City. Some of that is good. You should go out into the world ready to explore and learn. Be open to new experiences and experience and embrace all the opportunities to grow. To be outside of your comfort zone until one day you realize that your comfort zone just got a little bit wider and what was once a challenge is now just a part of who you are. But also remember where you came from and how we do things in New York City. At the New York City Urban Debate League, we teach students to use their voice so that they can become the next generation of diverse, informed, and engaged leaders. And if you didn't have the opportunity to try debate, don't worry. You might have missed out on a lot of fun, but it's never too late to develop your voice, to research, to question, and to think critically so you can advocate for yourself and your community with your professors and teachers, your employers, and maybe even your family. This is a new chapter. Use your voice to advocate for yourself, for opportunities, for fair treatment for you, and for those whose voices need to be amplified. As a high school graduate, you're opening a new chapter and walking out onto a much bigger platform. This world belongs to you. You have a voice, and our collective will is the very foundation of democracy. It is the decision of the majority to determine who will govern our nation and how, not of a few armed and dangerous insurrectionists. You have a voice to influence that majority, even if you don't have the ability to cast a ballot. You have the ability to speak up about injustices in other states and around the world. And you have the obligation to speak up about injustice in your community. Dr. King once said, "In the end, we will remember not the words of our enemies, but the silence of our friends." You must not be silent. Out there in the world, they need some reminding of the lessons we learned in kindergarten. We love everyone exactly how they come. Each person is beautiful and different, and we embrace that spectrum of color because we need all of those colors in our world. It is our job not to change people, because we can't, but to help them become the brightest version of themselves so that we have the most vibrant rainbows. That diversity is the fun. Our teachers also told us that every person has a right to be safe and that there is a thing called personal space. We as a community make decisions about what we trade for that safety, and we as individuals decide when, where, and with whom we share our personal space. You must use your voice to protect our ability to be to safely be who we are in our brightest, loudest colors and to make our own choices. You may be thinking, my one voice does not matter. But it matters to you, and it matters to me, and it matters to the person you are fighting for, and it matters to the world. You can do hard things. The last 2 years have proved that. And a little heart makes all the difference. Intech is absolute proof of that. Margaret Mead once said, "Never doubt that a small group of concerned citizens can change the world. Indeed, it is the only thing that ever has." So go, graduates, into the world, New York City strong, Bronx strong, Intech strong, and use your voice to change the world. Congratulations.
Good morning, parents. Good morning, students. Good morning,
I'm Ms. Velasquez, the new Pilot Coordinator for Intech Academy. It's a pleasure for me to be here today. And I'm gonna say, parents, you did it. PTA ladies, we're gonna start with Ms. Sandra Nagman and Ms. Heather Slater. So, Ms. Sandra Nagman,
please come here.
This is PTA president.
Good morning. Congratulations to both of you and to you parents that you did a great job. I just look at it in front of you, and this is your future. And take advantage of it. And good luck to all of you in your next chapter of your life. Good luck. The PTA is going to present a few awards, and this award is presented to Mr. Ricardo Pacheco in appreciation and recognition of your support to our community, Inter Academy, and Title I.
Thing you have done for Intech Academy, for our children, and for our community.
Today, we honor you, Ms. Alexandra Gaston.
Yeah!
Community and future leader goes to Kayla Silva.
next award is from Assemblyman Jeffrey Dinowitz, Community Service Award. This goes to Saul Benden Vogel.
Good morning, everyone. So now we would like to give the two awards from the New York City Comptroller, Brad Lander, Student Achievement Award. The first one goes to Destiny Joseph.
Thank you. Richard Welling, Certificate for Outstanding Citizenship, Service, and Leadership in Student Government. Daniela Ashenfeld.
Not just for staff, not just for the community, but for our students. And so I'd like to present this award in recognition of your dedication to the InTech Academy students and families, Mr. and Mrs. Sandra Naughton. As a commendation for your coordination of student activities at InTech Academy, this award is presented to Ms. Nancy Phillip. So I may have to steal the speech the PTA said, but in recognition of your exceptional excellence in making sure InTech is supported and runs smoothly, this award is presented to Mr. Ricardo Pacheco. Unfortunately, she couldn't be here today, but ensuring that you guys had a yearbook and other activities that took place this year, Ms. Camilla McKinnon. And then lastly, someone who's been part of our InTech community for a long time is really dedicated to your success as students, to our community's success. As a commendation for your steadfast dedication to the students and families of InTech Academy, Assistant Principal Andrew Gooden.
Through song. Now, imagine a hammer.
We all know that the purpose of a hammer is to construct and to mount things. Both of these objects have their respective purposes. Now, what happens if we try to use a guitar made to play music to nail something onto the wall? We all know that the guitar would break. The guitar would break because it was used for something it was not made for. Guitars are made for making music. That's their purpose. And the same goes with our lives. Each of us has a purpose. The same way only a guitar is capable of creating music, each of us has a mission only we are capable of completing, only we are capable of creating. And as long as we keep trying to use our lives for something we were not made for, we're going to be broken as that guitar is broken. However, let's keep some perspective here. We cannot know our plan right now. We cannot know what the future will bring. Our plan, our purpose, isn't set in stone. The truth is, there is no linear path. There is no formula for bringing or for figuring out what life will bring. But what we do know is that we shouldn't be afraid of the struggle. And Pope Benedict XVI, my personal favorite, puts this in a beautiful way. He says, the world offers you comfort, but you were not made for comfort. You were made for greatness. Oftentimes, we feel discouraged when presented with traditionally tough tasks. But we shouldn't settle or stop simply because something seems hard. Rather, we need to acknowledge that every good thing derives from a struggle, and every good thing that has led this world to progress has been a product of someone saying, I am made for something much greater than what this world has to offer me. We must be those people. Part of denying comfort and pursuing greatness is sacrifice. In college and at work, there are lots of things that we will have to sacrifice for the sake of reaching greatness. But two things that you should not sacrifice are love and happiness. If we don't have love and happiness, we can't say that we have found our purpose. Because without these two things, we cannot have an impact on other people. Because only love can change the world. We can change the world with our radical love. And part of love is accepting that we all have our individual strengths. And when we accept that, we become even stronger. Saint Therese of Lisieux writes about this in her book. She says, he opened the book of nature before me, and I saw that every flower he has created has a beauty of its own, that the splendor of a rose and the lily's whiteness do not deprive the violet of its scent, nor make less ravishing the daisy's charm. In a nutshell, right, St. Therese writes that the beauty of a rose does not take away from the beauty of a lily. By the same token, the skills and the strengths of your friends and of other people that you will encounter do not take away from your own. Your capabilities are your own, and no one can take them away from you. The world is in need of a love that only you can provide. The world is thirsting for strengths only you have. This is what makes the missions in our lives so specific and so beautiful. So as you continue to fulfill the missions that you already have and go on to find new ones, don't become complacent to what the world wants. Love radically and trust in the abilities that you have. It has been an honor getting to know each of you at Insight.
Thank you, Samantha, for those wonderful words. And now we will continue with the Warden of Honors, and I want to call up Ms. Santana. Excuse me, Ms. Porter-Correa.
to two students. The first one for the Bronx Borough Citywide Office Science Achievement Certificate for second place at the Bronx Borough Wide Science Expo goes to Yamil Pantaleon.
Scholarship, among them. So, you're going to be the founding principal. previous principals here as well, have donated a check to Jocelyn, so congratulations.
And persistence to achieve college and career readiness. It goes to Jocelyn Oliva Salas.
So again, the Salas in the front here. This award also comes with a scholarship.
Roger. Okay, and now the English Language Arts Department would like to acknowledge the following students. Graduates, please stand when your name is called. For their outstanding achievements in English Language Arts, Fatima Chowdhury. For their outstanding dedication in English Language Arts, Shania Silveria. For their outstanding dedication in English Language Arts as a second language, Michelle De La Rosa. And the UFT Award for Outstanding Achievement in English Language Arts goes to Khadija Mohan. Award for Achievement
for achievement in music goes to Elani Hernandez.
And the UFT Award for Outstanding Achievement in goes to Ashley Uriarte.
Acknowledge the following students for demonstrating knowledge and skills in passing the Virtual Enterprises Assessment. Graduates, please stand when your name is called. Ariana Acosta. Fatima Chaudhry. Daniela Flores Nepomuceno.
That figure there, if you saw, was $1.7 million in scholarships that you guys earned.
Gustavo Oriel, Dina Mohammed. I'm the past president. Okay, guys. And I want to just give a round of applause for Mr. Seltzer. We all have come so far that I'm so proud of you guys. I'm gonna cry. I'm not gonna cry. We all have come so far, and it's been an honor to watch you all grow up. And in fact, we made mistakes, we learned from our mistakes, grew from them, and we made so many memories that will never be forgotten. And for that, I thank you guys. You guys gave me so much memories, and I'll forever cherish them. You guys made high school worth it, to be honest. Amidst everything we've encountered, we made it through this school year strong and we persisted. Although we couldn't have our regular dances and tap rallies, we have our annual block parties. We did spirit weeks, car washes, and paint nights to lift us all, which I think worked. Maybe it didn't. Anyway, this year's student government was nothing like I've experienced before, but I hope we made your last year count. I'm able to stand here today because of my family, my friends, and the teachers who guided me. I'm so thankful for my Oma and Wapa for not letting me drop out of high school. Because I want to drop out of high school so bad. Yeah. My parents couldn't bring me, so I ran for them. Thank you for my sisters, for being my blue friend, and who helped me with my math homework. I'm thankful for Ms. Emsworth for being my teacher, mentor, and best friend through my high school years. Thank you, Destiny, Aileen, and Madison for giving me extra cheese sticks during lunch. And Ms. Oaks, my cheese sticks. Every single other Monday, I'll get these cheese sticks. I love them so much. Thank you, Mr. Weisberg, for giving me opportunities to strive in, and thank you to my student government family who agreed with me for these past 4 years. And to my cat, you're the realist. You're the reason I'm here. As a community, I don't want to talk about the sad parts, but we've loved, but most importantly, we've survived. Thank you, class of 2022, for being strong, funny, and successful individuals. I'm going to seriously miss all of you guys, like from the bottom of my heart, I mean it. Just kidding. I'm gonna miss you guys. Okay, and I believe in each and every single one of you guys. Like, each and every single one of you guys. You guys got this. You guys got this! You're the future. Congratulations to all of you. Remember to always slay the day. With all the good morning fintechs I've said, today we say goodbye to tech. Till next time, Panthers! Now, I know I'm harassing you guys to send me videos, and now I put it all together.
So we come to the part of the graduation ceremony that we're here for. Before we fully get there, I think it's important to acknowledge, you know, what some of the speakers said before about community service, community activism. We decided this year to be part of a pilot with New York State to certify and recognize our students for being civically minded and will get seals on their diplomas for the work and activism and projects they've done in our school since they've been at INTEC. And so we have over 55 out of 120 graduates today receiving that certificate and seal on their diploma. And lastly, before I have you stand, there's two people behind me that need to stand up, and you guys need to stand and clap for them, Ms. Wache and Ms. Rodriguez. They don't rest, they don't sleep, they just breathe, making sure you guys have what you need. And that's not a lie, and it shows today. So thank you. All right, graduates, please stand for me. So it's the honor of being your principal and being my first graduating class, by the power vested in me by the New York State and New York City Department of Education, I declare you graduates.